Yes. like a switch when you came around and all the pieces pick me up and put me together. Oh, these are the days we've been waiting for. Days like these, you couldn't ask for more. Keep on coming, because we're not done yet. These are the days we won't be with. These are the days we won't forget. These are the days we've been waiting for. Rattle the cage and I'll slam that door. And the world is calling, but not just yet. These are the days we won't regret. These are the days we won't forget. Found you, cut through all over town. You made me bleed when I look up and I turn around, but I'm in pieces. Pick me up and put me together. These are the days we've been waiting for. Never reverse knows what's in store. You just pull your hand out and place your bets. These are the days we won't regret. These are the days we'll never forget. These are the days. Under the tree where the grass don't grow, he made a promise to never get old. You had a chance and you took it on me. Heartache, heartbreak, all over town.
in store. You just quit when not have a place to go. These are the days we won't regret. These are the days we'll never forget.
Yeah, these are the days. Daniel Gilbert has rightly quoted, "The human brain is the only object in the known universe that can predict its own future and tell its own fortune." When you hold your fate in your own hands, why not learn to make the best of it through psychology? A very good morning to one and all present today. I, Maharshi Sharma, Assistant Professor, Department of Economics and Psychology, St. Xavier's College, Jaipur, welcome all the participants. Career development is a lifelong process which reflects one's interests, abilities, values, personality, and background. Career counseling is a process to help you understand yourself in the world of work in order to shape your career, education, and life decisions. St. Xavier's College, Jaipur has organized this career counseling conclave to help students to understand the course and career choices available to them. I welcome all the participants to the session, Career Cognizance, Psychology, the New Age Course for Future Development. We are delighted to have with us Reverend Father Dr. Sherry George, Vice Principal, St. Xavier's College, Jaipur. I would now like to invite Ms. Purvi Meritwal, Head of the Department, St. Xavier's Department of Economics and Psychology, St. Xavier's College, Jaipur, to deliver the opening remarks and enlighten the students about the department.
Thank you, Marshi. Good morning, one and all. Reverend Father, Vice Principal, staff members, and my dear students. I welcome you all to this virtual counseling conclave, Career Cognizance Psychology, the New Age Course for Future Development. Psychology is a fascinating area of study. Psychology is one of the few streams that require no specific subjects or group of students to pursue. Students from any stream, being it science or commerce or humanities, can apply for psychology courses. There are numerous career avenues when it comes to psychology, as it offers various specialization streams. And in this ever-growing world, people don't really find time to think of their individuality or their mental health, and it is essential for psychology experts to offer them solace and enhance their positives. The Department of Psychology at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur, functions under the aegis of the Department of Economics. It has been established with the vision to ensure the undergraduates attain reasonable grounding in psychological theories, approaches, and applications in order to fuel further the motto of academic excellence at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur. The department faculty aims to inspire and support students in their journey of learning and success. Besides classroom teaching, seminars, research papers, class presentations, workshops, webinars, symposiums, and guest lectures to augur the expansion of knowledge. The students are encouraged to initiate research and academic writing, as well as to transform into better decision makers across life's opportunities. In the end, I would like to say that hopefully you find this session enriching and it assists you in making informed educational and occupational choices. My best wishes. Thank you.
Thank you, Purvi ma'am.
Now, I would like to invite Ms. Nupur Chauhan, Assistant Professor, Department of Psychology, to begin the session with an ice-breaking activity for our participants. Nupur ma'am, kindly unmute yourself.
Nupur ma'am, you're not audible.
Okay, now I am?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, students. So now we will begin our session with a small ice-breaking activity that helps all of you to introduce with the subject. So some terms are going to be flashing on your screen one by one, and let's see what do you understand by these terms, or simply what comes to your mind when you see these terms. And students, these terms are very, very simple, so don't be scared and let us all participate enthusiastically. Ready? Here we go. Let's have the first word, mental. You can write your responses either in chat box or you can unmute yourself. Come on, students. What is mental? Okay. Mental. What comes to your mind when I say mental? Okay, let's have the second word then. Disorder. Okay, Priyal responded that it is a brain-related function maybe. Yes, Priyal, absolutely correct. Disorder. Pranav. Pranav is here in the meeting. What is disorder? Come on, students.
Okay,
this is the session for all of you.
It refers to any kind of maladaptive functioning.
Yes, maladaptive function. Correct. Then psycho. This is the term that we use in our day-to-day life. Whenever we turn angry, we say that he's psycho or she's psycho. So what is psycho? Come on. Show some energy, psycho. Mentally disturbed. Okay. Therapy. So if someone turns psycho, what is needed? What is therapy? Either psychological or physical. What is therapy? Come on, try harder. I am psycho. Okay, Aditya. So you definitely require therapy. Enough? Okay, next, bipolar. Bipolar. What is bipolar? Any idea? A mood disorder. Absolutely correct, Pranav. It is a type of mood disorder. Next. OCD. This is also very common. Disorder associated with episodes of mood swings ranging from depressive. Okay. To anxiety. Okay. Absolutely correct. So all of you have some or the other idea. Okay. The last term, psychoanalyze. Psychoanalyze. The scientist or the academician that is associated with it. Any idea? Yes. Sigmund Freud. Absolutely. The father of modern psychology. So all of you, I'm sure, have some or the other idea about psychology. And these are some terms that you will learn more about in our subject, that is psychology. So this was a small ice-breaking activity which was organized to to start the conversation with us. The entire session will focus on two-way conversation, students. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nupur ma'am, for this wonderful ice-breaking activity to kickstart this session. So ma'am, to begin with, an intriguing question in the young minds is, what are the future academic prospects after pursuing psychology? So please highlight them.
Absolutely correct, Marshi ma'am. So whenever we choose any subject for our graduation, be it psychology or be it any other subject, the first question that comes to our mind is how it can help me to shape my career or how, whether it will be beneficial for me or not, what I will do in it. Okay. So in order to ease your understanding, students, we have divided this question into three slides. Let me first begin with the academic prospects. Yeah. So when you attain your degree, graduation degree in psychology, you may opt for further education. You may go for post-graduation degree, that is master's degree in psychology from various reputed institutes of India like Ferguson. You can go for St. Xavier's Mumbai, Mitibai, Christ University, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, or if not master's, then you can also go for PG diploma courses in various specializations. It can be counseling, family therapy, rehabilitation. And students, if you are interested in research, then you can also go for MPhil or PhD. So these are some of the academic prospects that you can pursue after attaining your graduation degree in psychology.
Moving on, the most crucial part of any higher education degree are the career prospects and opportunities that are available after it. So ma'am, please highlight the same for BA honors in psychology.
So not only we have variety of options available only for career academic prospects, but we also have diverse number of career opportunities available to us. So you can be a licensed clinical psychologist, counseling psychologist, school counselor, family or couple therapist, academician, to name a few. So depending upon your interest, you can choose to be any one of these, okay? So I can say that psychology is like a big umbrella that covers a variety of career options for all of you.
Thank you, ma'am. Furthermore, to gain hands-on practical knowledge while studying, students are keenly interested in doing internships. So please highlight, why is it important to do an internship and what are the areas where students can pursue internships in psychology?
So students, in the previous two slides, we talked about academic prospects and career opportunities that you can do after your graduation, right? But at Xavier's, we also recommend our students to undergo internships during their graduation so that they can also, you know, learn the application aspect of the theoretical knowledge that they're getting in the classroom. Okay? For example, if I talk about intelligence, if I talk about personality disorders, if I talk about behavioral therapy, but until and unless you don't practice it, you won't be able to learn the skills required to utilize them properly, okay? So here, internships and fieldwork play a very, very major role. So depending upon your interest, you can choose to do internship under various private or government hospitals. You can choose to do internship under a psychologist or a therapist, under school psychologist, under sports psychologist, or you can also do an internship under various mental health that run at various colleges.
Thank you, ma'am. You have highlighted, I believe, the most important parts and the most crucial part of a career counseling session. Now, coming to our department, I would now request you to list down the academic courses that are offered by the Department of Psychology at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur, for the students.
Thank you, Maharshi ma'am. Now, this is very, very important, students. So now I would like to introduce with our department at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur. In our department, we offer two major courses in psychology. The first one is BA Honours in Psychology, and the second one is BA Pass Course with Psychology. Now, students, both these courses are a three-year degree program with annual examination scheme. Okay, but in BA Honours with Psychology, you study four papers each year. Whereas if you go for BA Pass Course with Psychology, you only study two papers each year. So I can say that BA Honours in Psychology is more advanced in nature than BA Pass Course with Psychology. Now, in order to have more clarity, I'll show you the papers in the next slide. But before that, let's also talk about the subsidiary subjects and the elective options. Okay. So once you opt for BA honors in psychology, there are 6 subsidiary subjects that you can choose. This can be English, economics, political science, sociology, history, or public administration. Whereas if you opt for BA pass course with psychology, then there are different combinations that are available to us. For example, you can go for English, public administration, and psychology. You can go for political science, public administration, and psychology. And students, these combinations are also available on the official website of Xavier. So you can also check it from there.
Thank you, ma'am. You have highlighted a very key difference between BA pass course and BA honors in psychology for our students. Now, apart from this, I would also like you to inform the students about the extra courses that are offered by the department.
Very good question, ma'am. So in order to have overall development of our students, we run different short courses in our department. So there are 3 short courses that we run currently. First is the Swayam course. It is a program that is launched by the Government of India. Okay. So last year we offered 2 Swayam courses. The first one was Great Experiments in Psychology, and the second one was Consumer Psychology. Now let's also talk about what is Bridge course. Now we offer Bridge course in Elementary Statistics. Students, let's be honest here. How many of you are scared of numbers and calculations? You can type your responses in the chat box. How many of you are scared of numbers and calculations? Come on. Even I was. Okay. So Priyanshi is. This session is interactive. Yes. If this is trigonometry, then I am. Aditya, this is not trigonometry. So don't worry here. Okay, fine. Now, as most of the students are scared of maths, calculations, or numbers, so we offer this course, Elementary Statistics. Why? Because we have one paper in first year by the name of Foundation in Statistical Psychology. And there, we use simple 10th grade level maths. Okay? We all know the simple 10th grade level maths. But in order to brush up your mathematical skills, we offer this 15-day bridge course in prior to beginning your session. And then we also have certificate course. Apart from imparting the regular courses, we also offer certificate course in order to broaden your horizons of learning. This year, we planned for certificate course by the name of Science of Happiness. So in this course, we'll try that you can analyze your own self, be it your strengths, your weaknesses, your interests, and aptitude. And this course can also help you in developing your stress coping mechanisms. Let's move on to the next slide.
So, ma'am, for clarity of students, can you please show the list of different papers that are offered in BA Honours Psychology and BA Psychology pass course?
Definitely, ma'am. So, students, here you can see a list of papers that we offer in BA Honours in Psychology and BA pass course with psychology. Now, you can clearly see and compare here that in each year in BA Honours, we offer 4 subjects. Whereas in each year under BA pass course with psychology, we offer only 2 subjects. Okay, that is why I was saying that BA honors in psychology is more detailed and advanced than BA pass course with psychology. However, in both the courses, we offer practicals. So just like you have your physics practical exam or chemistry or biology practical exam, you also need to give exams of practical under BA honors in psychology as well as BA pass course with psychology. I'm sure I'm clear with the papers here. Students, if there is any doubt, please write your queries in the chat box.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ma'am, for this interesting and enriching presentation. I would now invite Ms. Shiromi Chaturvedi, Assistant Professor, Department of Psychology, for another ice-breaking activity for our participants today. Ma'am, kindly unmute yourself.
Hello, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and the slide is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so a very good morning to all the young, bright minds present with us today. Before we delve deep into the world of psychology and our department, I thought that we should use an application, a quick, fun application of psychology and how it's related to personality. So is everyone ready? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you an image. And when you see the image, the first thing that you can identify in the image, okay, you have to type that down into the chat box. And Maharshi ma'am will let me know, you know, what answers are coming in. So if everyone's ready, give me a thumbs up. All right. Now I'm going to present the image. First thing that you see. So, do we have any responses?
Yes, the responses are coming in. So the responses are tree, a lion, an old tree. Most of them are saying tree, a tiger.
Okay.
Another response, birds.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. So now based on these responses, I'll tell you a little bit about your personality. So for those of you who saw a tree or an old tree, any version of a tree, you are basically honest and rational people. Your friends often come to you for advice. You are a natural leader who is very skilled, and you already know what are your capacities and you'd work hard to enhance them. Now, were there any responses for lion and tiger, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so people who responded with lion or tiger, you have a strong personality and you are an influential person in your friend circle. You push yourself, you know, and others around you to strive for excellence in whatever field you want. And you also learn from any obstacles that you may face in your life. Any other responses, ma'am?
We have a response of gorilla and birds as well.
Okay, all right. So for my students who have responded as gorilla, so you are perhaps a highly analytical person. You search for a deeper meaning in life and in day-to-day things. So you seek opportunities to constantly perfect yourself, since you believe that there's always room for improvement and constant growth. And for those of you who saw birds at the first prompt, so you are people who are dreamers and idealists. You like to observe your people and surroundings. You believe in yourself and you are free-spirited, generous, and kind.
Thank you so much, Shiromi ma'am. I believe all the participants really enjoyed this ice-breaking activity.
Yes, I do hope that it gave them a little peek into their personality. And of course, they'll get to learn a lot more when they join us here at St. Xavier's College Department of Psychology.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. So moving on with the session, ma'am, apart from academics, as we have discussed till now, students also have a keen interest in the extracurricular activities that are offered. So please highlight such activities that are organized by our department.
All right. So we actually have two flagship events. I think when you were joining us and we were waiting for participants, you've already seen what Synergy, our annual department fest, looks like. So I'll first start with the Mental Health Week. In order to promote mental health, we dedicate a whole week in October, which is filled with activities such as interactive sessions, movie screenings, mimes, psychodramas, intercollege events, which focus on raising awareness around mental health issues in the student community, in the faculty community. And basically, our main aim is to reduce the stigma that is associated with mental illness or asking for help. You know, so we want it to be okay to not be okay. And for this mental health week, we invite, you know, industry experts, leading psychologists, professors from across the country, so that students may get to speak to them one-on-one or interact with them through a virtual medium. Moving on to our annual department fest, we organize this in collaboration with the economics department. And this event is Synergy, which has a team of over 75 students, and we have participation from across the country. This time we also had participation from across the globe. So students plan a lot of events. They are fun, interactive events with emphasis on academic learning as well as leadership and team building skills.
Ma'am, apart from these flagship events, what are the other activities that are organized by the department for student enrichment?
Okay, all right. So as you can see, St. Xavier's has always invited, you know, leading industry experts for guest lectures. We do this both in a, face-to-face medium, also on a virtual medium. We have also invited international eminent personalities to kind of address our students. We also place heavy importance on research. We are one of the few colleges in the country who emphasize research work right from an undergraduate level, which really sets aside our students from other students. You know, so we encourage our students to conduct research. We have workshops to guide them through the process. Then we hold a national symposium in which students from across the country present their research papers on significant themes. And we also have some other events, you know, some other fun events, such as movie screenings, a department picnic, or a department farewell, so that the bonding between the students of the department can be enhanced. And we also have student exchanges with our allied colleges, such as St. Xavier's Bombay, St. Xavier's Kolkata, and Loyola College Chennai.
Thank you, ma'am. It is known that the right infrastructure is crucial to support the academic and extracurricular activities. So please highlight the infrastructure facilities that are available for the students at our department.
Okay, so this year we have shifted to a beautiful 30-acre campus at NAVTA. So this time we will be hoping that you join us there, right? All our classrooms are ICT enabled, so it makes audio-visual learning, very, very easy. We engage in a lot of group discussions. It's not just, a monologue from a teacher to a student. We like interactive sessions, as you can already see. Another thing which is fundamental to our department is the psychology lab. So all our practicals are conducted in real time by our students. We have 12 practicals as recommended by the university every year. This is more than any other college offers in Jaipur. So this gives you real opportunity to, experience what it's like to be a subject and a experimenter, right? To learn how experimenting or testing works, which is a very, very fundamental thing in psychology. Other things that are of note in our department is the department library. So we have set up a department library in order to inculcate the habit of reading, sharing, donating, amongst students. And we also plan to start a new initiative this year, which will be a discussion forum every month, so the students can choose a book and we can have, combined discussions and analysis of that book or the theories highlighted in that book. And the last thing that we offer in this department is the department blog, which is completely run by students under the guidance of the faculty. So we keep updating the blog with the, upcoming things in the department and around the country. This year, we also plan to start a biannual psychology newsletter in which we will be discussing the trends in psychology, the upcoming researches across the country and globally.
Thank you, ma'am. So, ma'am, a well-organized student body is crucial to develop leadership and teamwork skills among the students. So please highlight some details of the department society.
All right. So I take immense pride in telling you all about, our department society. So we have three student-led initiatives and teams, which are really the backbone and the spine of our department. So the first is EcoSoc. So in association with the Department of Economics, the students of psychology and the students of economics form this society, which is known as ECOSOC, right? And this gives a platform to the students to interact with each other, to organize events. So from the beginning till the end, they are the ones who ideate, who brainstorm, who plan, who arrange and execute under the guidance of their faculty members. So ECOSOC is, you know, the primary body that does this. It's a student-led body. It also works in close association with our Xavier's department alumni. Then we have two other student-led teams. The first is Arthika. So there's a team Arthika every year. And in this is our department magazine. So we publish articles by the students, the department activities that have taken place through the year, any relevant other information that needs to be highlighted. And this is completely curated by the students and the chief editors of Team Arthika. And similarly, like I said, we place a heavy importance on research. So Illuminatus is our research journal. So we not only promote our students to do research, you know, and learn research in the research workshops, we get them to present their research in our national symposium, and we get them to write the research and publish it in our department journal, Illuminatus, so that when you go for your master's, you already know the basics of writing and conducting research.
Thank you, ma'am. Lastly, I would like to ask one more question, that looking at the current academic scenario, while applying for higher studies and job opportunities, research and publication is sought after by institutions and employers. So what are the research opportunities that are available with the department?
So as I have been highlighting, we place a very, very heavy importance on research. So each child in our department gets the opportunity to do at least one research project. Multiple times they get the opportunity to do 2 to 3 at a national level or an international level. We always encourage them to not only present it, but write and publish it. So this year, these are some of the research projects that the students did under the guidance of their faculty members. So as you can see, there's a wide range of variables that we studied. So we studied quality of life, resilience, hope, stress, social participation, use of technology, gender expression, mental health and well-being. And a lot of it this time was in conjunction with the theme of the year, which was COVID-19. And we studied these psychological variables in different populations. So we studied, say, the mental health of doctors. We also studied the psychological well-being of mental health professionals themselves. We have studied stress levels and depression levels across, say, police personnel, women, mental health professionals, students, adolescents, daily wage workers. So whatever your interest area is, you will get, you know, hand-holding and guidance based on that. And you will learn how you can, think of an idea and then translate that into a research paper.
Thank you so much, Shiromi ma'am, for presenting such a holistic view of the department and its associated activities. Now we have finally arrived at the Q&A session. I would now invite the students.
Before that, I wanted to show one more small thing.
Sure, ma'am.
All right. So before I close from my side, let me also give you a glimpse of the shining stars of our department who have brought laurels to the department in different fields. So as you can see, they have achieved laurels in sports, extracurricular, co-curricular, research, and academics. So you can have a quick look. These were some of our shining stars for the year. And this is what some of them had to say about the department and why they love it here at St. Xavier's. We also have some video messages from our students. They wanted to speak to you directly, so they've specially recorded this for you. So I'll just take 2 minutes and show you some of their videos as well.
Ma'am, could you please switch on the audio as well?
Sure, ma'am. Is it audible?
Hi, everyone. I'm Taisha Banaya from the first batch of BA Psychology Honors at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur. I'm thrilled to have new people joining us this year. In my experience, I realized that my classmates are open-minded and my teachers are supportive and approachable just after a few classes. We have participated in webinars, research projects, clubs and committees, competitions, internships, certificate courses, and Synergy, as well as Zest. I'm proud to say that despite our small size, our efforts and active participation hasn't gone unnoticed. It is important for dedicated people like you and me to pursue and spread awareness about psychology. While psychology has always been an important subject, its need is growing by the day. Psychology is a diverse and vivid experience. I hope you start off your year in BA Psychology Honors at St. Xavier's with hope and excitement. Thank you for listening and goodbye.
Hi, my name is Corvi Mittal. I'm one of the first students at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur, to study psychology honors, and I'm glad to be one. Psychology has always been a personal favorite subject to me. The most important perk of studying psychology is it gives you the understanding to solve the problems you face in your daily life. It helps you to ease out things you find difficult. This college offers a good practical learning experience in psychology and favorable advice from the mentors too, who themselves are very intellectual in this field. I wish you a good experience in comprehending psychology at St. Xavier's College, Jaipur.
Greetings to one and all present here. My name is Vasundhara Purawat, and I am pursuing my bachelor's degree of psychology honors from St. Xavier's College, Jaipur. Psychology has always been an intriguing field of study for me. It made me believe in the positive philosophy of humanistic development, and therefore I'm glad to be under the guidance of this institute, which has not only provided me with an excellent academic platform, but also a commendable support system of its faculty members. Being the first batch of this department, throughout the year we have experienced exposure right from the department and college fairs to international conferences, webinars, and internships. The Department of Psychology has given an impetus to our abilities and has moved us towards avenues of fulfilling growth. And of course, the everlasting college experience that we've all been waiting for since the last days of our school. With experience to shape us and memories to last forever, all of this was geared towards helping budding psychologists like us to acquire a broad outlook towards understanding human psyche. And therefore, I'm relieved to be under the guidance of psychology department at Xavier's. And I look forward to continue this journey of untamable knowledge. Thank you.
Xavier's psychology department is definitely one of the best departments here, not only because of the well-qualified faculty, but also because of the amazing opportunities that have been provided to me as well as my fellow mates. Whether it was the international conference where we got to present research papers in front of quite distinguished guests, or the major research project by the research cell under which we worked under our mentor and got to learn a lot. These skills really are necessary when it comes to pursuing a field like psychology, and I'm grateful for it.
Over to Hashi, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you, Shiromi, ma'am, for showing these student videos. I'm sure this must have given our participants a much more holistic and actual view of the department activities and what the students feel about the department. So now we have come to our question and answer session. I would now invite the students to pose their questions to the faculty members. You can unmute yourself, state your name, and ask the question. You can also type your question in the chat box. So I would highly encourage the students to pose their queries to Ms. Nupur Chauhan and Ms. Shiromi Chaturvedi. Ma'am, there is a query from Priyal Khandelwal.
PL is asking when can they go and visit the campus.
Students, if you wish to visit the campus, you can come during college hours and take the admission. But for now, we are going for blended learning. In this, some classes can be taken online and this others can be taken offline. For now, we are starting with blended learning, but obviously you can come and visit the college during college hours. Students, please ask if you have any queries. Gauri, I have already cleared on this. So after you take your graduation degree in psychology, obviously you can opt for further education. You can go for master's, you can go for MPhil, PhD or PG diploma. You have number of career opportunities available at your end. If you take up this degree in psychology, you can be a clinical psychologist or a counselor or a family therapist. Okay, so it all depends on your interest, Bitte. Now, and during your graduation also, you can also take up different internships. Even right now, our students are undergoing internship under Fortis Hospital.
Just to ma'am, another field where you can really explore yourself is industrial or organizational psychology. We've also seen that students with a background in psychology are sometimes great candidates for MBA or, you know, a great addition to a sales or a marketing or an advertising team, since they really understand the human mind and the human psyche. So consumer behavior is something that really companies now why psychology students for, in order to, you know, help them grow their profit. So it's not just fields of psychology, but, you know, different fields as well. Especially if you learn research skills properly, then the roles of research analysts or, you know, joining a team which has roles in research, that also can be done with an undergraduate degree in psychology.
Students, if you have any queries, please post it in chat box.
Anything else, students?
Ma'am, I think meanwhile, we can discuss some of the things that have been posed by students regularly.
Do psychologists read minds? I'm sure if you had psychology in your 11th and 12th grade, there are many friends and family members that come up with this question. Oh, you have psychology. Can you read mind? Now, next time, tell them confidently that it is impossible to read human minds. But what psychologists do? Psychologists develop mental models. They do researches. They develop theories that can allow them to interpret human behavior, thoughts, and feelings. So definitely, we do not read mind, but we identify the causes and interpret the human behavior. Next question.
All right. So why are MA honors psychology at Jaipur's the best choice for students wishing to pursue psychology? So, you know, I'm sure there are lots of colleges that are offering BA honors psychology, and you might be confused. So, like I've already highlighted, the kind of activities that we do, the emphasis that we place on research, our affiliation to a government university, all of these are highlighting factors. More than that, the whole ambience of the college, where you will see, which is more liberal and which will give you the space to grow. While there are teachers to assist you and mentor you, you will be given the full freedom to explore your potential to its fullest and to achieve your dreams in a, you know, spirited manner. So I think that is something which you will only find at St. Xavier's and not everywhere else. Also with the new campus, there's so much more to explore. You will be, you know, learning with us in person and also online. And we will be arranging some really enriching development programs throughout the year. So we are looking forward to having you here with us at Xavier's. Nupurna,
kindly unmute yourself.
Amazing question. So what is the difference between a psychiatrist and a psychologist? Now these titles, psychologist, psychiatrist, these sound similar. Both are trained to diagnose a disorder and treat a disorder. Yet both psychologists and psychiatrists are not the same. Each of these professionals, psychiatrist and psychologist, have a different educational background. They have different training and different method of treatment. Let's go in a bit detail over this. So psychiatrists have a degree like MBBS, and then they can prescribe medications to treat mental disorders. Whereas psychologists have more advanced degree such as PhD, and they use psychotherapies. Variety of psychotherapies can be utilized to treat mental conditions. This can be psychoanalysis, behavioral therapy, cognitive therapy, then logotherapy can also be used. So you will learn about all these therapies in detail in your graduation. And depending upon the characteristics of the individual, preferences, the problem, the nature of the problem, you can address the issue likewise and apply the therapy. So psychiatrist and psychologist both treat mental disorders, but the method of treatment is entirely different.
All right. Another important question is, what is the scope of psychology in, say, IAS or other competitive exams? A lot of you may not wish to pursue any of the careers we have mentioned. You might want to go in for, say, an MBA exam or an IAS exam. So psychology is a great tool to have in your kitty, because this is a very broad subject and it gives you deep understanding. Also, once you understand the principles, it's easy to learn, you know, so it's not like history or other subjects where there are a lot of minor facts to remember. There are basic principles. So once you understand them, they are easy to memorize, so they can really assist you. Also, you know, when you're pursuing jobs or other competitive exams, there are usually interview rounds. And knowledge of psychology really helps you there, because you understand what happens with verbal communication as well as non-verbal communication, right? You also see that, you know, your critical thinking and reasoning skills are really enhanced by this subject of psychology, which helps you in all kinds of exams, whether it's CAT or ZAT or GRE or GMAT. So psychology is a subject that if you study it, it forms a great base for whatever else you want to learn in the future.
Could you please explain the affiliation of the college? Definitely, students. So our college, St. Xavier's College, Jaipur, is affiliated to University of Rajasthan. So when you get to do your final year exam, you will get a degree of University of Rajasthan. It is a government degree. So when you go for masters or when you go for jobs, it is valid everywhere. There are colleges that provide their degree of their own. So some colleges might not accept it, but this degree is universally accepted everywhere.
Yes, ma'am, and that's very important, you know, because sometimes if it's a university, you know, which is giving its own degree, sometimes their accreditation may be revoked and then the students have to suffer. So which is why a state university degree is, you know, always safer and better. Now, for the last question, what kind of guidance is provided for future courses and exams like PSMAT or Masters or MPhil? So students, I would like to tell you that we have, organized coaching for competitive exams such as IAS. We will also be organizing coaching for CAT, you know, and so on and so forth. We also provide guidance to TISnet specifically. Since I'm a TIS alumna, it's easier for me to guide you and tell you, you know, what will help you in the exam and the interview. Nupur ma'am has done her MPhil, so she is very, very adept at research, and she can guide you as to how to crack different MPhil exams across the country. So we always, towards January, February, we have this session with our third year past course students as well as our honor students, you know, to kind of ensure that they are targeting the best colleges and universities for their future aspirations.
Thank you so much, Nupur ma'am and Shiromi ma'am, for giving such clear and crisp answers to all the questions. I would also like to inform the students that for any further queries, they can contact the faculty on the email ID. Also, students should note that the link to the admission form and the feedback form for this session is given in the chat box. So I would encourage all of you to fill the feedback form and also visit the college website for further details about the course and the admissions. Lastly, at the end of this session, I would like to thank Father Principal, Reverend Father Dr. A. Rex Angelo, and the entire management for giving us the opportunity to organize this career counseling session. I deeply thank the HOD, Purvi ma'am, Nupur ma'am, Shiromi ma'am, and other faculty members for delivering this valuable session. I'm certain that the students have immensely benefited from it and gained valuable insights. And we hope to see all the students becoming a part of the Jaipur family. Lastly, I would request all the participants to switch on their webcams for a group photograph. All right, thank you everyone for joining today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all. See you soon.
Thank you, Father, for joining.
Thank you, Father.